Hello, and welcome to this tutorial for BioXTAS RAW. In this tutorial, you will learn how to use RAW to make Kratky and normalized Kratky plots. This tutorial assumes that you have the results of previous tutorials, particularly the subtracted and Guinier-analyzed glucose isomerase and lysozyme data files from the tutorials for loading, averaging, and subtracting data, Guinier analysis, and molecular weight analysis. If you haven't already done those tutorials, please do those tutorials first and then return to this tutorial. If you have done those tutorials, you should see a screen in RAW that looks like this. Here we have the loaded glucose isomerase data. It's selected. You can see that it has Guinier analysis shown in the information panel. If we click on the lysozyme dataset, we can see it also has Guinier analysis shown here. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put these scattering profiles on what is called a Kratky plot. So if I right-click on the main plot, the top plot here, I pull up a menu and I can select axes and I can select Kratky. So a Kratky plot plots I times Q squared versus Q. To make this a little bit easier to see what's going on, the other thing I can do is show only the top plot on the screen. So if I go down to the bottom bar here, you can see currently it's on 1, 2, we're showing both plots. I'm just going to click on 1, which is going to show the top plot. So when scattering profiles are plotted on a Kratky axis, a nice bell-like kind of Gaussian shape like this indicates a folded scattering profile. An unfolded scattering profile is going to come up and then plateau, whereas something that has both folded and unfolded regions will have some amount of bell and then some plateau later on. So what we're going to do now is we're going to load two additional data sets. So I'm going to go to the Files tab, I'm going to go up a level, I'm going to go to the Flexibility data, and I'm going to load both the partially folded and unfolded data files. So if I go back to the Profiles tab in the Control Panel, you can now see that all four profiles are loaded. However, on the plot, we're really only seeing two profiles, the unfolded and the partially folded. The reason for this is that data can be presented on, and SAXS data can be presented on an arbitrary scale. So the intensity values for these two profiles are much larger than the intensity values for the glucose isomerase and the lysozyme data. They've just been scaled up arbitrarily. So in order to see them all in the same plot here, what we need to do is apply a scale factor to scale them back down. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hide the unfolded data, like so. So now we're just seeing this partially folded data. Then I'm going to click on this triangle here. For any of these profiles, this triangle lets us see more information and more controls for the profile. So once I click it, you can see that I can see the Qmin and Qmax values, and I could adjust those for the profile. I can also apply an offset and a scale factor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply a scale factor that's less than 1, and I'm just going to keep changing the scale factor until it gets close to where the glucose isomerase and lysozyme datasets are. To do that, I'm just going to hold down on this down arrow, and you can see the scale factor scrolls, and you can see that now we've scaled it to be on the same scale as the other datasets. I'm going to repeat this for the unfolded data. I'm going to show it on the plot. I'm going to expand it, and I'm going to scale it down until it's on the same scale as the others. So now all the data is on the same scale, and we can see that the pink data kind of comes up and has a level spot. It's what we expect for partly folded, whereas the unfolded comes up and just essentially has a plateau. So Kratky plots are quite useful. They can give you information about folded versus unfolded, but because the presentation of the Kratky plot here depends on the size of the macromolecule, they're not actually that useful for comparing between essentially the same shape at different sizes. It turns out both glucose isomerase and lysozyme are very globular, but because one is larger than the other, they look very different on the Kratky plots. So what we're going to do now is we're going to plot these on what's called a normalized Kratky plot. So I'm going to select all four scattering profiles just by shift-clicking. Then I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to select normalized Kratky plots. Now, ideally when you do this, you've already done Guinier analysis on all the profiles. Here we've done Guinier analysis on the GI and the lysozyme profiles, but we haven't done it for the partially folded and unfolded data. So what we see is we get this window that says missing Guinier analysis. We can either proceed using an automatic determination of the Guinier, or we could cancel and do the Guinier manually. I'm going to proceed using the automatic determination. And now the normalized Kratky window opens. So in this window, we see two main regions. There's the plot on the right, then there's the control and information panel on the left. So in the plot on the right, what you're seeing are the four different profiles. The colors correspond to the color bars here. And these are now plotted on a dimensionless Kratky scale. So instead of being q squared times I of q versus q, it's now q times rg squared times I of q over I zero and qrg on the bottom axis. This essentially removes the scale factors that come from the size, the molecular weight, and the concentration of the sample. In this case, you can now see that for glucose isomerase and lysozyme, which are the blue and the orange, they're showing us essentially the same shape, which is what we'd expect because they're both very globular and we've removed the effects of the size. And now you can see that very clearly the partially unfolded, partially folded and the unfolded are very different from those. On this plot, the dashed gray lines cross at where you expect the peak to be for a globular protein. This happens to be at a maximum of about 1.1 and at a Q times RG of about 1.73. We can also control what's shown on the plot over here. If I just check these checkboxes, you can see that that removes items from the plot, and then I can add them back. If you scroll over in the window, you can see the RG and I of zero values that are being used. Finally, if you click on these colors, you can change the color of the line that's being plotted if you want. There are several different ways you can display kind of normalized Kratky or dimensionless Kratky plots. If you click on the tab here, we can change to normalized, which is just dividing by I of zero. We can change to dimensionless with volume of correlation, which is essentially doing what the RG does except with volume of correlation. And then we can go back to dimensionless with RG. This is kind of the usual approach. This is what most people plot, is this plot. So that's what the dimensionless Kratky plot in RAW does. The one other thing I'll mention is that if you right-click on this plot, you have some options. You can add a legend if you want, and you can export the data as a CSV. So if you don't want to have to do the transformation yourself when you're making your plots, if you click on this, you can export all the data, and that will allow you to get these rescaled intensity curves without having to rescale them manually. Now I'm going to close the window. With that, that's the end of the tutorial. You should now know how to do Kratky and dimensionless Kratky plots in RAW.